Hey everyone, we're just going to give it a few minutes just to get started. But while you're waiting, if you want to drop in the chat where you're from, we'd love to see that. We're just going to give it a few minutes as the numbers trickle up. I see we got a Washington, DC person. That's where I am today, just visiting for the week for our Fitness Tech Summit. So that's exciting. Alrighty, well, I am gonna go ahead and get us started. For everyone, my name is Kayla Cannon, and I am with Club Automation, MotionSoft, and CSI Spectrum. And I am so excited that you guys have joined us for our encore presentation of our IHRSA session titled Game On, How to Provide Unrivaled Mobile Experiences. A couple bit of housekeeping before we get started. Everyone has been muted to cut down on background noise, but please feel free to add questions via the chat or our Q&A feature. We'll have time dedicated at the end for Q&A. We will also be sharing this as a recording afterwards, so just be on the lookout for that in the coming weeks, or not coming weeks, coming week. So with that being said, we are going to hop on in. So a little intro. As we emerge from the pandemic, your club is more essential than ever, with 67% of Americans citing health as a serious concern. While it's exciting to see the fitness bounce back, the game is to make sure you are standing out in front of others. Without the right tools in place, having a strategy to increase membership and revenue can feel overwhelming and disjointed. It shouldn't be impossible to outrival your competition and take your club to the next level. Today, we are joined by Club Automation's Senior Product Manager, Jordon Pflederer, as he discusses ways club acceleration platforms drive the member experience with essential mobile and digital tools. Thank you for joining us, and I'll kick it over to Jordon.
Awesome, thanks Kayla. Hello everyone, again, my name is Jordon Pflederer. Just a little bit about me, I'm based out of Chicago. I've been in the health and wellness world for about a decade, doing everything from personal training to coaching athletes, developing leaders, and now I'm a full-time nerd. So I, like Kayla said, I am a product manager and wanted to really share a little bit of the story behind what my team and I did the last 18 months. Everything from learning to researching to planning, designing, and then eventually building a mobile app that we really believe is a game changer for the health and wellness industry. So as we take you through today, as I take you through, you know, we're really going to break this webinar into two parts. So part one is going to be the research that my team and I did. Hundreds of hours, 18 months, like I said, of diving into, hey, what's the needs of the industry? What are club owners saying? What are members saying? What are prospects saying? And so there's a lot of research. So there's going to be a lot of data coming your way. You're going to hear a lot of percentages. I promise, just hang with me. It's going to be very, very fruitful. And then the second half is going to be our response to that research. So ultimately, we really just want to share the importance of mobile. But first, obviously we're here for mobile experiences, right? And building unrivaled mobile experiences. So let's have a little bit of chat here. I'm going to open up my chat. But first I want to talk about one specific statistic that blew my mind when I discovered this. So I know there's a handful of us here that have already tapped in the chat, but do me a favor and type in the chat, if you will, your guess as to how many times you as a person or the average individual touches their smartphone per day. the average number of times a person touches their smartphone in a given day. Yeah, keep them coming in there. I see 325, I see 45, I see 60. Keep it going. I know we got a handful of people. 1,000. Yeah, come on, let's get some more in there. 500, 400. Give me a couple more. There's no bad guess. 500. One more. Somebody wants it. I know they do. Too many. Mary, that is so true. I touch my phone way too much. 900, 1,500. Awesome. This blew my mind. 2,500 times. Is that crazy or what? I look at that and I'm like, oh my gosh. What a distraction to some degree, right? I think we all can agree that we're on our phones too much, but just to goes to show the importance of how we as consumers use our phone. We touch it 2,500 times a day. So again, I'm going to be sharing loads of information today to you. Again, we're going to do research and then the response, but on the research side, there are three key research takeaways, like kind of three themes that I want to share with you guys. And so Christy, you can go to the next slide. Let's jump in to the first one. Okay. Members expect to interact with businesses when and how they want. So obviously, expectations because of COVID has changed things significantly. 88% of customers actually expect companies in every industry to actually accelerate digital initiatives due to COVID-19. So when a member inquires about a process, you know, we used to, you know, some of the language maybe was like, oh, well, this is how we do business. Well, instead, now the member knows or consumers know, well, because of COVID, you should have altered the way that you've done business in the past because COVID's forced you to innovate so much that we're actually, you know, there's been 169% increase in restaurants offering online ordering. I don't know about you guys, but my out to eat budget shot through the roof during COVID because all I did was online ordering. So like, if you think about processes or activities or anything that weren't in a digital format, they now had to be made available in a digital format. And even in the fitness industry, right? One of the biggest shifts that we saw was at-home workouts. For me, you know, I used to go to a facility here in the city and obviously it was shut down. And so I had to figure out what I was going to do at home. And then in response to that, clubs then had to begin offering virtual classes. So maybe we have some, you know, some specific club owners or maybe fitness directors in here. Do me a favor in the chat, if you don't mind. Again, I love interaction. I hate not being able to be in a room with you all right now, but I wish we could all be together. But in the chat, let me know if you or maybe you were a part of a club that had to find a way to start offering virtual classes. Maybe just be like me or something like that. Or maybe you, even if you partook in a, you attended a virtual class. Go ahead and add that in the chat. I want to see how many of you get in there. Yeah, certainly. Yeah. Anybody else? Yeah. Yeah. I mean, to be honest, you know, my local facility, yeah, they're here, they come. Yeah. My local facility offered it. And, you know, when we were at IHRSA in Dallas a couple weeks ago, I went around and I said, hey, just show of hands. Who in this room had to take on the responsibility of creating virtual classes? And how was that? And there was a woman in the front row. I just raised her hand and she went on like a 45-second blurb about how hard it was. And I remember I just went right up to her hand and I just went right up to her. I shook her hand. I said, you did a fantastic job. I'm sure. Cause she talked about how difficult it was, right? Because as club owners in these facilities, these tools weren't readily available. And so I can relate a little bit to the club owners in the frustration at times to make sure that you continually offer those types of products to your members. And so really what we're seeing now is as members, you know, as this interaction has changed, they want more than just virtual classes. Now you have to offer me this. Now you have to offer me this. Well, I know that you should be changing. So now you should offer me the ability to buy packages for my phone, allow me the ability to buy a membership or even cancel a membership without actually talking to a single person. So this interaction is changing, but not only that, go ahead and go to the next slide, Christy. We're actually seeing 80% of members now expect a personalization as a standard of a service. So what that means is go ahead and give me all these things, but don't make me feel like a number. Like make me feel human when you're communicating with me. And so when I do get to the response side of our presentation here, I'll show you what we did in order to accomplish that. But I think what's even crazier about this statistic is that we found that actually 3/4 of these people that don't feel like a personalization as a standard of service, they actually will begin to visit the gym less and less and less, and actually start hunting for other fitness facilities. So the importance of a mobile experience being intimate, we found was tremendous. So let's go to the next one. Next slide, our second trend that we're seeing. Members are tired of having multiple apps on their phone. This is another, let's get back in the chat again. Forgive me if you're getting annoyed of the chat, but it makes me feel like there's some people out there. Without Googling, the average smartphone has blank apps on it. Throw a number out there in the chat. The average smartphone has blank number of apps on it. 50. Come on, give me some guesses. 75, 50. Yeah, 40, 35. Yeah, the average smartphone has about 80 apps on it, okay? 30 of them you use monthly. 9 of them you use daily. In addition to that, the average consumer, not even fitness, you know, guru per se, you work out 3 to 5 to 7 times a week, they actually have 4 to 5 health fitness apps on their mobile device. So why so many apps? People are looking for convenience. At the end of the day, if I use an app and I can't get what I want out of that app from a few taps or a few steps, I'm out. I'm going to go find another one. I'll pull it down from the App Store or the Google Play Store. And the same thing goes for members within a facility. They're like, oh, well, do I have to go to your website for this? Do I have to go to your portal for this? Do I have to come to the front desk for this? Do I have to go find the bulletin for this? Do I have to actually talk to a trainer for this? Members are tired of having to go to all these different avenues. They want everything in one place. Not only that, so go ahead and go to the next slide, Christy. We're actually seeing that 56% of members expect to accomplish any of those given tasks within 3 taps. So this is what's really important. And for me, this was pretty eye-opening as we were doing some research, because obviously, you know, no one is downloading a fitness app to just, you know, numbingly scroll for hours like we sometimes do with social media, right? And so they came for a specific reason. So we actually are seeing the same utilization with fitness apps as we are with map apps like Apple Maps, Google Maps, in Waze. So you come in for a specific task. I need to get from point A to point B. In the fitness world, I need to easily see the schedule screen or see however I can book a class. And within 3 tasks, I got to get in and I got to get out. And so what we found then was we really aren't operating in what we would call a B to C world, even though we truly are. Like, as a product manager, I'm building mobile applications for consumers, but really the experience is that of a B to B, business to business. So let me explain the difference. So in a B to C world, business to consumer world, you're typically, the consumers are okay with the fluff, the extra stuff, maybe some promotional material, that ad that pops across YouTube for the first 30 seconds before you can actually watch the video. The experience is expected to maybe throw some things at them. It's kind of, hey, swoon me in the experience. Well, with fitness apps, we're seeing it's more like a B2B experience. I need a straight line from A to B. I don't need all the bells and whistles, but make it elegant, make it seamless, and make it easy for me. And so that was an adjustment for me, to be honest with you, because that's not kind of naturally how I am as a person, but that's actually what the majority of members are desiring. So we had to create an app that would make members feel like they're accessing a centralized hub, and whatever they chose to do, they could do it within minimal taps. And let's move on to the third and final trend that we saw. Different generations are engaging with gyms differently. So we're talking about baby boomers, Gen Xers, millennials, Gen Zers. In today's world, there are 10 communication channels, everything from paper to person, to phone, to email, to SMS, to AI. And so how can we take this information and say, okay, how can we build a mobile experience that can adhere to all those different types of communication channels? And so not only did we let engage equal communication, but we also had to have it be experience. So each generation desires something different, right? So how we can build a mobile app that appeals to not only baby boomers, but all the way to Gen Zers. We're not here to build something flashy, for that Gen Zers want to woo and wow at, or something super intricate and complex with a variety of animations that then actually confuse the older generation. You know, my parents, they're in their 70s. And I probably get called 4 or 5 times a week. And, hey, son, we can't figure out how to do this. I'm like, okay, dad, well, grab mom's phone, FaceTime me, FaceTime mom's phone with your phone so I can see your screen. I'll walk you through how to do it. And so we have to build something that's easily usable across all types of generations, right? And so whether that's the person that typically wants to walk up to the front desk, it's a 70-year-old member that you have, and say, hey, I need some help with this mobile app. I'm not sure how to do this. But what we actually saw, though, in looking through a variety of data points is that convenience is still king across every generation. So, and let me explain a little bit more. So when comparing it to brand users, all generations still prefer convenience. So fitness facilities, you know, with first-class reputations, they can flounder if they don't make it easy to do business, right? As the purchasing power of digital natives increases, the definition of convenience is also shifting too, right? So all generations prioritize convenience over brand, but actually it's particularly true for Gen Zers, even more so. So we'll get to a little bit in the designs when we get to the second phase, kind of how we built something that I really believe accommodates all the generations. And what's crazy, if you go ahead and go to the next statistic, Christy, our final statistic here, is that 76% of members prefer different channels of communication depending on context. So what does this mean? Your channels of communication must provide continuity. So I want to be able to start it over here on my laptop through this website, and then I want to be able to finish it over here on my mobile app. So not only that, but members are saying, hey, don't bark at me with loads and loads of push notifications about your latest promotions. Get my attention for the things that really need my attention. For example, I've added myself to a wait list. I want to receive a push notification when I've been added to the class. And at the end of the day, each individual has their own preferred means of engagement. So it's really up to you all, you know, for those of you that have a staff position or owners of a fitness facility, to look at your members and say, okay, where's my dominant generation here? Am I serving that generation on how they like to be served in forms of areas of communication? You know, we're seeing that the typically email and phone work best for Gen Xers and for baby boomers. And then we're seeing millennials and Gen Zers are the ones that say, hey, give me the push notifications. And so learning how as a facility to utilize those tools. And then also we have taken the opportunity to automate some things from the mobile side too, that's going to assist in that as well. So we're going to take a break now from research, and we are going to move on to the response. So really what we're looking for here is it's all about experiences. It's all about growth, and it's all about efficiency. So experiences, growth, and efficiency. So let's go ahead and dive right in, Christy. Obviously these can all be achieved through the mobile app that we're showcasing for you today and the importance of it. So the first one, unrivaled experiences. I'm going to take you through 4 things here. Your members expect to be able to schedule courts and classes, track fitness goals, access all your apps in one spot, gain insight into class offerings, instructors, et cetera. So let's move on to the first one. I encourage you here, if you're not full screen, go ahead and go full screen so you can utilize the image here that we have on the left. This here is what we built in response to some of the research data points. So the biggest one being, hey, get me in and get me out within 3 taps. So this is our new schedule screen. So booking reservations on the go with this brand new screen that we've developed. So you can see across the top there, we have the calendar. But what really made the difference here in our testing was having this simple line of what we call quick filters. And so depending on the number of filters that are engaged, gives you the number there off to the left side. So within a few taps, I can determine, hey, what location do I want? What category do I want? Which instructor do I want? Are there preferred times? And then I quickly am filtering through all that information below. But not only that, I'm actually getting the category, the class name, the time, and the instructor all within one tile, but then getting the call to action there. So you can see for that first one, for body pump, hey, I can sign up, but for Zumba, looks like Alex is all booked. And so I'm going to have to join the wait list for that one. So again, just being able to seamlessly put as much information in a clean way on the display screen. So within a matter of a couple of taps, a user can sign up for a class. Let's go to the next slide. tracking health and fitness goals. So this was something that we, to be honest, we're still kind of greenfielding. It's crazy what's out there. There's some super powerful tools out there. For me, I have an Apple Watch. I use it daily when I track my workouts. I've got a handful of friends that also use Whoop. But here we discovered a way just to, hey, how can we elegantly and simply bring health wearables also into our mobile applications so you can track steps and miles? In addition to that, you actually, for those of you that have an Apple Health Watch, what we've done was we've used Apple's open APIs and we've tapped into workouts. So I wish I could screen share my Apple Watch for you, but I can't. But for those of you that are Apple Watch users, you know, when you go to an Apple Watch and you start a workout and when you finish the workout, it would actually display here on the screen. And this is something that we're looking to continue to grow into, and there'll be more on the future for this. So be sure to keep your eyes open in 2022. Let's go ahead and go to the next slide. The explore screen. So you'll see there at the bottom on the nav bar, the explore screen is highlighted. I would say this might be the most favorite yet simplest thing that we thought of. So it's being able to access fitness apps in one location, but not only apps, it's more than that. So on this particular screen here, we've created actually a staff tool that allows staff to create these titles. So you're seeing on-demand, activity, childcare, and spa, and then you're seeing the icons. So really it's creating this centralized hub where you as a club staff can tell your members, say, hey, go to the explore screen. Everything that you need is there. Perhaps you use a spa booker and you don't use Club Automation's native selection. So right there, then you could just tap on spa booker and you could go and you could be redirected to another experience, whether it's another mobile app or whether it's another website. The same thing goes for on demand. You can see that tile that's on there as well. So let's say that at your facility, you know, you have some on demand classes that are actually behind a YouTube playlist, or maybe it's on Vimeo. By tapping on that tile, you actually redirect your users to that experience. And so no longer are you left having to send out emails or have, you know, flyers all over your facility say, hey, you know, scan this QR code for this, go here for this. It's, you know, anytime someone comes up to the front desk or they communicate with you, say, hey, actually everything that we do, all of our offerings are right in the mobile app. And it's really easy to use. Just go to the explore screen. You'll find exactly what you're looking for. Let's go ahead and go to the next slide. And this is the final slide for Unrivaled Experiences, gaining insights into class offerings and instructors. So this is the second screen that you see after clicking on sign up. Again, just being able to learn a little bit about the class in the about section there at the bottom, and then learn a little bit even about the instructor as well, looking at their bio, taking a look at the other classes that they offer on their schedule. So then after I would have tapped on sign up right here, you could see that I would have signed up for this class within two taps, which is an amazing experience for your members. So let's move on to the next section, unrivaled growth. Your members expect to be able to easily reserve or book again, purchase classes and memberships online, and select class models, hybrid class models for shifting behavior. So let's go to the next slide. Really, really proud of what we figured out for this specific feature for members. For me, I'm a habitual, I'm gonna make up a word or a phrase, I'm a habitual worker outer. So my wife is the same way. You know, she's gonna go to Body Pump every Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 5:30. And so this section, again, if you look over on the left side in the upper section, it says reserve again. What we've done is we've offered 10 classes, up to 10 classes I should say, based off of your historical activity. So let's say in this specific example, we'll just look at the first tile there, how it says yoga on January 10th on Monday at 6:15 p.m. What this is saying is, hey, Jordon, you actually took yoga before this date at around this time and with this specific instructor in this specific room. So what it's doing, it's intelligently offering me future classes based off of historical events. What this is doing is this is allowing another opportunity for users to quickly get in there, be like, hey, I took that class, but what filters did I use? Or how did I get there? And say, hey, actually, you know what, Jordon, when you log in, we know you took this class. Here's a class in the future. And here's another class in the future too, based off of what you've taken. So super, super proud of the ability there, even for our members to experience something so seamless and easy and elegant. And then of course, the next slide, enabling online memberships and being able to purchase classes. So again, being able to download the app, create an account, buy a membership, sign up for a class by purchasing for a class, all within the palm of your hand without having to go and communicate with a facility. Because ultimately, you know, if you go back to one of the first research points I talked about, you know, members expect to communicate with clubs on their terms. So I'll admit I was one of those people. I joined a new facility in the city and I wanted to do everything online. I said, I don't want to have to go in the city and I want to have to talk to anybody. You know, it's COVID times. I would like the ease of just downloading the app, buying the membership, paying for a class, or just being able to walk right in through the doors as if I was a member for the last handful of months. And so we have that ability here within the app as well. The next one, provide hybrid class models for shifting member behavior. Let's go to the next slide. Awesome. So you can see here, you'll notice on the left side of those tiles, there's a little camera icon. This is something too that, you know, we saw this big shift, right? I would say as COVID began, we saw lots and lots and lots of facilities and clubs need virtual classes. But then what we're seeing now is it's dying off a bit. And to be honest, maybe more than a bit, kind of significantly as places are starting to reopen. However, there's still this hybrid desire, meaning, hey, this class is going to be available in person or online. And so we've created a solution for that as well. Simply by just being able to utilize third-party platforms, whether it's you're hosting on YouTube Live or Twitch, or you're hosting on Vimeo or any other live streaming provider, being able to hook that link up into the back end and say, hey, body pump from 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. on this day, you can actually sign up for this class and then watch it live. This is a huge offering, but not only for clubs in the then, but also moving forward that we think is going to be really, really powerful. And let's move on to the last section, unrivaled efficiency. Your members expect to be able to receive automated push notifications for class updates and keep up to date with new offerings and announcements. Let's go ahead and go to the next slide. Kind of back what I talked about around push notifications. This is gonna be really big for your millennials and your Gen Zers. Hey, don't pepper me with a ton of push notifications because I don't care as much about the promotions, but give me the push notification instead of the email when it comes to joining a wait list. And so we've gone through and we've added a handful of automated push notifications. So even for this specific instance, we have two options when it comes to wait lists specifically. You can either A, drop the person to the class automatically when a spot becomes available, or B, you could ask them if they'd like to be dropped into the spot. What's awesome about this push notification is right here actually on the lock screen, if you were to tap on that notification, you don't even have to enter the app. You could actually then click join or decline right then and there. So again, within a matter of two taps, you've already chosen whether or not you actually want to enter this class. And then last but not least, we want to give you the opportunity to drive new revenue with promotional announcements. So this what's happening section there that you see in the center. We actually found that what I thought maybe wasn't going to be that powerful of a tool, to be honest, we kept on getting feedback from clubs specifically saying, I need a tool that does something like this, something like this. And so I went back to the team, we did some more research and I said, hey, we need to develop something that can be used as an announcement tool for anything. Hey, COVID protocols have changed. We got to alert everybody within a matter of seconds, write a blurb, hit post, and then it's displaying on our mobile app. Within a matter of seconds, hey, actually, it's holiday hours, we're closing early. Hey, a pipe burst, we're closing early. Hey, here's actually some core power yoga on demand video that our trainer would like to highlight for you. Go ahead and tap on that video and you can watch it. Not only that, but hey, here's some camps that are coming up. Here's some programs that are coming up. Here's a special that we're offering on some spa packages. Any type of that promotional marketing material also right available here in this what's happening section. So for those of you that are with Club Automation or have been with us, the Club Announcement Tool is what achieves this feature, which is shown to be an incredibly powerful tool. So really excited about that. But yeah, that's really it. Wanted to just say thank you. Obviously, I know I think Kayla's maybe going to open it up for some questions, but would love to hear your thoughts or feedback if you have any questions. And Kayla, I'll pass it back off to you.
Yeah, thank you. So like Jordon said, if anyone has any questions, you are welcome to drop them in the chat. And I do have a few already. So the first one is, can push notifications be pre-scheduled?
Pre-scheduled. Yes, they can be. Yes. So those notifications are scheduled at a specific time and they can be altered. So that is something that feel free to reach out to Club Automation support and they can get you squared away.
Awesome. Another one is, are these features all available in the current mobile app?
Great question. So right now we have about 90% of them available. This transparency of the schedule screen is being wrapped up. I'm hoping it's our Christmas gift to all of our users. So for those of you that are using our mobile app today, you'll see three icons across the bottom: home, explore, and profile. But in my prototype, obviously you saw four. So that fourth one being the schedule option, that's going to be coming out at the end of the year, beginning of next year. So it's in progress.
I have one more that Great. Came through. It is this app integrated with Club Automation?
Yes. 100% integrated with Club Automation. We really pride ourselves in its ability to be so closely knit to Club Automation. I think it's what makes the app so powerful, to be honest with you. You know what? I see another question. I see Jennifer just posted something. So sorry, Kayla, I'll jump in. Are there plans to integrate the ability to make childcare reservations into an app feature? Yes. I can confidently say there is. Actually, it is something that we are developing next year. So keep your eyes peeled. It will be a deliverable for next year for sure.
Any other questions? And if not, I am also going to drop in the chat our email. If there are any questions, you guys are welcome to email marketing@clubautomation.com. And we would be happy to help you with any of your questions. Oh, I think we actually have another one.
Awesome.
How would this app appeal to boomers?
Yeah, great question. How would this app appeal to boomers? To be honest, we tested it with the boomers and we basically said, are you confused by anything? And the typical response was, I'm reluctant to change because it worked fine the first way. Why did you change it? And so what you'll kind of struggle with the boomers is, well, why change it if it works? Whereas Gen Zers and millennials will typically respond with, well, like, give me something new and something fresh. And so from the perspective of how will it respond, I mean, really, it's going to have to be your boomers getting used to change. But as far as the complexity and usability of it, we've tested it with enough boomers for it to be successful in regards to, hey, I don't know how to book a class. That was never feedback that we got. So I would just take time in educating your members. Just know that obviously anything that's changing, there's going to be questions. And so there'll be that time of stretching for your staff as you respond to those questions. We have a ton of materials out and available to you all on our knowledge bases, as well as our release notes. And so please check those out. If you need to get access to those, reach out to our support team. They will direct you. I created the one sheeter and the FAQs. So any clarity that you need on how to kind of help educate your members is all out there.
Any other questions? Well, if not, I just wanted to thank everyone for your time and also thank Jordon. And just as a reminder, we will be posting this recording. So just be on the lookout for that. And thank you guys for joining us.
Thank
you. Bye, everyone.